push a little dirt today, so maybe I can see out the side. Yeah, you might be able to see a little better. I'll show you what's going on. Keith is piling up dirt right here in the front, and we're going to push it to the back. Now all I'm doing is making a big pile back here. Putting all the good dirt up here, that way we can get ready to bury all the debris. We've got a bunch of trees and stuff we're going to bury. Get it out of here. out of his way. He gets away from his where he drops. Watch, he'll come and drop. He'll drop right there. So I need to get out past where he can reach me. Then I can work without worrying about him hitting me. Or him looking where I'm at. I'm gonna push this all the way through. You gotta take a shovel and clean it off. What I do is once I get up here, what I'll do is I'll let that blade down just a little bit like that, then I'll back up and it pops the bottom and lets it go. If I don't and you try and just shake it, it won't even come off. Dig a big pond, you stack all this black gumbo mud on the side. Once you dig your clay pond and get all your clay out of it, you push all that back in it and you line it with this stuff here. And when it rains, that water is crystal clear. It's like green or blue. It's not that murky pond water color. If you line your pond with this gumbo mud, it just seals. And it's pretty cool. Back at home in Dry Creek, it's so red a clay. When it fills up, we got brown water like 3 or 4 years before it finally settles out. But I'm gonna try and line topsoil in my ponds at home when I build them. And we're gonna test it at home. So I've been watching some other guys work on the state up here. Watching them build a pond and they line this back in here, and then when I come back by the next week after it rained, the water was like green, so it was real pretty water. So that's something pretty cool. I just figured that out while I was up here. So make sure the camera's still sitting up back there. Thank you. still got a bunch of land where you can put some more facilities. We got some empty space up front for the high visibility part of it. We got a couple parking lots that wanted, some of the tenants wanted a bigger crushed cement parking lot. They're trying to work all that stuff out. Once they get that done, then we'll go over and do that for them.
Thank you.
pushed the pile right to the hole. Makes it hard when I get close to the edge. I can't even pull it out of there without knocking something in there. Shaking, you feel like that? doesn't even do any good with that mud. Dozer work. Let's see y'all later. Let's see how it turns later.